Hey folks, it's Rodney Urand with OTS Training, and today I want to talk to you about all of the different ways to retrieve your email, both on and off campus. Now, depending on where you are in the world, you're going to want to use different solutions. Let's take a look at them now. Let's start with on-campus email. Once you've logged into a machine on campus, you have a full Outlook client available to you. It is the best solution. You'll have access to your inbox, calendars, tasks, and folders. You'll locate Outlook on your computer by either searching for it using the Start menu or selecting Outlook from the Microsoft Office folder. Now, once selected, the computer will recognize your account and auto-configure the Outlook process. Just follow the steps and you'll be presented with the full client. Depending on how much mail you have, it might take some time to retrieve all of your messages. But rest assured, after some time, your mail, calendar appointments, contacts, and tasks will all be there. Remember, this software package will give you the most features. Next up, we'll cover retrieving email or calendars when you're away from your office. This could be in a classroom, across campus, at home, or while traveling. To easily retrieve emails, calendars, contacts, and tasks, you'll want to use the Outlook web app. This is a scaled-down, web-based version of the full Outlook client. It won't give you everything you need, but almost. You can access the Outlook web app via the Office 365 portal at office.towson.edu. You'll log in with your campus email address and your password, and then you'll select Microsoft Outlook. All of your content will be there. The only thing is that it's using a web-based app, and that limits the functionality somewhat. And finally, there is a third option available to you if you have a smartphone, something like an iPhone or an Android device. You can either use the built-in mail settings to retrieve mail and calendars, or you can download the Microsoft Outlook app from the App Store of your favorite phone. We prefer the Microsoft Outlook app because it gives you a lot more functionality. However, if you do access your email on your phone, you will be required to add password protection to your phone. I've provided links to the step-by-step documents that will help you set up mail at the end of this video, but you can also find them on our self-help documents page. Thanks for watching. For more information, please visit towson.edu/OTS training.